Hey guys, welcome back to Jeeva Shastra Abhyasa. I'm your educator Niranjan Hegde. So let's finish off the first thing. If you're new to this channel, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel because it's easy and free. So in this video, we will be discussing about incomplete dominance, the theory, a little bit of history, and an experiment which is very important for board examination as 5 marks. And also, it is very important for your NEET syllabus even. So then what's the wait? Let's begin. Incomplete dominance is stated as the dominant allele, which is incompletely dominant, dominant over the recessive allele, and which produces an progeny which is an intermediate character, which is intermediate character individual or progeny with respect to the parents. So let's study these all things. What are all these things which are separated? It's a complete statement of this incomplete dominance. That is the dominant allele, which is very dominant, which shows its characters, right, on the recessive parent. So here what happens in this particular incomplete dominance trait, that is, it is incomplete dominant, means it cannot express its character completely, which ultimately produces an progeny which has an intermediate character, means yaradu character galanna hondirtave, that means from the parents and also from the male parent and the female parent. So yaradu character galanna hondirtave, which will make a new individual, evolutionized individual we are going to get in the progeny. Both of the characters from the parents will be seen in a single species. That is the statements defines as for the incomplete dominance. So then let's see who has discovered this particular kind of trait. So the phenomena of incomplete dominance was discovered by Karl Korenz, who is a German biologist, and he discovered this feature before the Mendel's work. It has been discovered, but it didn't came to the light after the Mendel's work only. When it came to light, then this particular phenomena came into the light. So that means, so there were a lot of plants were seen that this particular phenomena was going on. And for example, he has seen this particular example in two plants. So one is Antherium species, which is also known as Snapdragon, and another one is Mirabilis jalapa, which is also known as 4 o'clock plant. So here is very important thing, that is Antherium species is a legitimate example which has been given in your syllabus, board syllabus, either it may be CBSE or state syllabus, NCERT syllabus. That is Mirabilis jalapa is very important in terms of your NEET syllabus. So we are going to study how he has learned about this experiment, and we will learn how he has conducted Karl Korenz, and what results he got through the Antherium species, that is Snapdragon, which may be asked for 5 marks in your board examinations. He considered color of the flower in the plant, that is Antirrhinum species snapdragon. So what are the two colors he considered? The color he considered was a red color, red color which has been termed as capital R, and he has took another one and he crossed it with the white color, that is considered as small r. He considered them as parents. Okay, so when we start crossing it, so we get gametes, right? Gametes. So that gametes was capital R from here, and here he got small r. Okay, two gametes has been came. So then what happens next? Next, fusion. Of course, you all know that fusion takes place. Capital R, small r is going to come. So both were homozygous individuals which are pure in nature. And we have expected, as we see in monohybrid cross, we have expected that. So this particular result as F1 generation should be an heterozygous red. But as a result of this incomplete dominance, so it came to be heterozygous pink. So here he stated, and he confirmed this law that, so the dominant allele of the progeny was unable to express itself completely or dominantly over the recessive white color. So which made us to get the pink colored plant in it. And also he continued that into the next generation, that is F2 generation. So let's see what happens in the F2 generations when he considers F1 generation as the parent. Okay, so I'll not write a parent gamete, all those things, we'll directly do that. So capital R, small r, which is heterozygous pink, he considers this as a parents in F1 generation, and the gametes will be released, that is capital R and small r, here also capital R, small r. So these both are heterozygous individuals, pink colored plants both are, and he inbreeds them and he gets if you consider F2 generation, we can consider through both the Punnett squares, whatever we can, Punnett square, or directly we can cross it. So if we take it Punnett square, it will be male, I consider male and female. So capital R, small r, capital R, small r. So capital R, capital R, capital R, small r, capital R, small r, small r, smaller. We get four different plants. So as you can see, so I'll cross over here also. So I'll write this particular results over here as the results were capital R, capital R, capital R, small r, capital R, small r, and small r, small r. So that represents capital R represents what? The first parent, which we consider in Antirrhinum species or snapdragon. So that is red, homozygous red it is. And we get two of the heterozygous pink in the F2 generation. And here we get homozygous white. So these are the results what he got in the F2 generation. So that created a very confirmation about the incomplete dominance, as so whenever the dominant gene fails to express itself completely, so then there will be incomplete dominance will be seen as a result. So we get as a phenotypic character, we get 1:2, 2:1, because in monohybrid cross we got 3:1, three tall plants, one dark plant, but here we got one homozygous red, two heterozygous pink, and one homozygous white. And genotypic character, that is here also, that is 1:2:1, because of the same nature of presenting or failing itself while while in the progeny of the dominant allele. So this was the incomplete dominance. I hope you understood the point. And in it, so this same question may be asked on Mirabilis jalapa, which is also known as four o'clock plant. So this was the experiment conducted by Carl Torrens on the incomplete dominance, so which is legitimate and which is very important for your board examinations. I hope you liked this video. If you like this, put a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel because it's easy and free. So until next time, let's hit the road of success together. Jai Hind.